this is the Young Gryff, the prince that was promised, and is I the Golden Joeblivion. And we are back. Last episode, I will say, first of all, this episode, I am very surprised, because when we left off last episode, we were able to get a resounding victory against the Lion in King's Landing, King Tommen of the Iron Throne. Right, we have his, yes, we do have his young wife is in our dungeons, yes. She's in house arrest, is she not? She is. And we cannot seduce her because she is not a, or because she is a prisoner. But I am kind of concerned. I know we have 53% war score, and we did get a resounding victory, but, ooh, Vela Targaryen, I forgot about her. Plot to rescue, surely King Tommen wouldn't kill her. He might. She is but a baby, but he might do it, because King Tommen can be ruthless at times. But the war is still very much ongoing, and it wouldn't be impossible for us to still get killed, for us to still lose the war here. We did take King's Landing, and we won a resounding victory. I'm thinking... Well, let's see. They're all pulling back to Faring Cross. Some are pulling back to Faring Cross, but it seems the vast majority of them are moving on to Stokeworth. Let's pursue. Now, I thought they were all going to go back to Faring Cross, and if that were the case, I would actually say let's not pursue, because there is an army of almost 10,000 coming up from the south. Mostly from the Vale. But if they're pulling back to Stokeworth, we should be able to catch most of them still broken with their morale down. But the Vale armies will march through here to King's Landing. And if they want to attack us, they'll have to cross a river, which will give us the advantage. Whereas if we were following them down south, they would just come and join and, potentially put victory in danger. What is Alan Cave doing? Oh, I think Alan Cave is someone we're trying to convince to help us kidnap King Tommen. Yeah, so you can see Alan Cave. Oh, there he is. And he is Master of Whisperers of the Iron Throne. If we can get him on our side, we got this. We got this. I'm pretty sure we already sent him a gift. Oh, we didn't. Do it. It's worth it. It's worth it. See if he'll join us now in our plot to kidnap the king. So we don't really have to worry about trying to take King's Landing anymore. Master Derek of Fishville. He's complaining about his dark cells. We will be merciful. In fact, we might even release him. So I don't see what danger that guy poses to us. In fact, who are our prisoners? We have five. Andrea Frey, Jaime the Kingslayer. We need to make sure we don't release anybody who's helping our war score. Right now, Marcella Lannister is a huge boost, as well as Lord Jaime. So Marcella's in a dungeon, I believe. She's in a dungeon, and I mean, we could put her in house arrest, but we're not going to do that because... It makes it really easy for them to escape. Queen Marjorie's on house arrest. If she escapes, that's okay. Jaime Lannister, we're not going to let him escape. Qyburn, we can ransom. He'll give us 25 gold to do so. But I believe Qyburn's kind of important. But it doesn't say he is. Alrighty. Walder Rivers, are you guys my... You're my defense experts. We don't really need defense experts right now. Instead, we need to have speed. Roland... Martin and Benedict, you guys are going to be organizers. We need speed to catch this army, and we know organizers can be amazing for that. Okay, so battle's been joined again here in Stokeworth. We have them. They've already broken because they were already shattered from before. But with this army of 9,600 soldiers, will arrive on the 26th. So in 3 days, they'll be in King's Landing, and this battle has to be over. They'll probably attack us, but they'll be crossing a river, I believe. No, actually, from King's Landing to Stokeworth is completely open. Oh, shit. All right. And they're coming straight for us, which could give them the advantage. My lord, news from all realm provinces. I don't care about that. Okay, this is kind of concerning. They may actually have organizers in this army, too. The first of the eighth moon. Damn, this could be really bad for us. Something someone else mentioned, was raising a small splinter force so that we can go and, so that we can go with Aegon and capture a dragon, because supposedly that's going to help us. If I raise these levies, they're going to raise, this is the group I would love to use. But they're standing right in the way of an army. So we're going to have to disband them. They're going to come out of Griffin's Roost. We will use them, but we have to wait for this army from Iron Oaks to get out of here. Really wish Estermont would help us. Ah, damn it. Okay, now they're coming in on us. We have a day. A day. So let's get Walder. Let's get our defense experts, Garth. There's another one. There he is, Harwood. So now, when they attack, we get a 25%... Oh, we get 20% morale defense and 10% defense. This will hopefully give us the advantage, because they're coming in on us right now. They'll be here, I think, the following day, and we're going to be caught at almost 50% morale. Not good. Whew, not good. And we can't really escape. We just have to hold. There they are. Oh, this is not good, ladies and gentlemen. They're at full morale. They're at full morale, but we seem to be holding the line. Come on, break them. Break them. Despite not being his opponent in war, I still feel as if I can try to reaching out to Lord Allen in some way. Let's meet under an armistice. I have decided, oh, he has decided to trust us. I will make my reasons clear. And it seems we've gotten the better of them. Now, if we had kept our organizers in that battle, we probably would have lost. So you can see the kind of playing the general roulette, the general or the commander roulette can be very, very useful. It's kind of tedious, but it can win you your battles. Now, will Alan Cave join us in this plot? He still will not. Let's see, opinion of Lord Paramount Aegon, opinion of King Tommen, political concerns against King Tommen. Yeah, but I mean, it won't be that bad, buddy. It will not be that bad. We're already sowing dissent in King's Landing. There's not much more we can do. Just keep winning the battles, I suppose. If this army does join... Yeah, the AI is getting desperate. Lord Allen? Oh, no, your enemy, Lord Ralph Buckler. I don't know why I said Allen. Okay, he's been captured. And despite winning that battle, the war score hasn't really moved. See, Battle of... Okay, Battle of Grand View, Occupation, Battle of Sow's Horn. We've got more armies. They're coming in on top of us. The AI is just trying to win through attrition now. We cannot let them. All right, this army is still dicking about in Griffin's Roost. That's where my troops are. That's where I need to get. I need those troops. So Alan almost likes us 100%, and he still will not join us. It's because he's scared about King Tommen. He doesn't know what King Tommen's going to do. Because King Tommen is a familial kinslayer. Who did he kill? I can actually look it up. He killed Daenerys Stormborn. He killed Catelyn Stoneheart. He beheaded Lord Stannis. Who did he kill that was his kin? I don't know. But I do know the enemy is desperate. And they'll be arriving right now. God, these crazy bastards. And they're coming back with more. They're coming back with more. News from the Battle of Stokeworth, my lord. Your enemy, Lord Jason Malister, has been slain. Our armies here have been devastated. I'm not sure. Oh, wait. Now they're back. What is going on? Oh, my gosh. What is the AI doing? Your enemy, Lady Anya Waynewood, has been captured. News from the Battle of Stokeworth, my lord. Your courtier, Sir Garth Hightower, has been slain. Garth Hightower was one of our defender experts. Yeah, that battle in Stokeworth. But we did get the best of them. Okay, so with that guy gone, I'm thinking we would probably should get another defender replacement. Or maybe we can get someone who's good at... Aenys is good at flanking. I want somebody... leads from the rear. Defense plus 20%. Unyielding. Heavy infantry leader. Trickster, would he be good? He's a good defender expert. So if we're going to chase this army now, chasing this army would probably be the best thing we can do. Siege of the Red Keep. Oh, no, we own the Red Keep. We cannot let this army, we have to pursue them. If we get our organizers, do we have anyone who can lead the center? No. Do we have anyone who's an organizer who is good on the flanks or anything like that? I don't think so. Lord Harlan of Adderdell. Lord Harlan, what do you offer us? I don't actually know. What is he actually, oh, here he is. He is a defender expert, right. We just picked him. Sir Walder Rivers, actually. So, Benedict Broom is an organizer. Sir Roland Storm is an organizer. Sir Walder Rivers is a defending expert. Sir Martin Rivers is an organizer. Harlan is a defense expert, and Harwood is a defense expert. So we've got defense experts and organizers. We could switch them all out. to these guys. But they, like, battle-wise, they really don't have a lot going on for them. And I do feel like... I mean, what are the odds that we're going to lose, though, if we pursue this army to Hayford? I mean, they're going to have no morale, and we have some. I've never seen a shattered army turn around and defeat a pursuing attacker, and we cannot let this army regain their momentum. Where are these bastards? Are they still in Griffin's Roost? No, they're not. Which means we can make our move. Shipbreaker Bay. Raise the rest of these levies. Get Aegon in here. Aegon, you're forbidden from command, are you not? Yes. Get Aegon here. Get him on the ships. And where are the dragons? Watch, if Aegon gets eaten by the dragons, he'll be very upset. We've got Drogon, who is being tutored in Mother's Valley, which I think is an... it's obviously in Essos. It's up here. Mother's Valley is kind of the place where Andalos began. Viserion is also in Mother's Valley, and Rhaegal is in Marine. I think somebody said that Aegon should go for Rhaegal because it befits his personality, but Drogon is way better. Strong. Wrathful will make him harder to tame. Viserion has no traits, and Rhaegal has Wrathful and Playful. So taming chance is 1.5. Dragon egg chance is 1. Oh god, I'm losing my ability to see with my eyeballs here. Personal combat chance goes down. Personal combat skill goes down. So, oh, but personal combat skill goes up with Wrathful. So it kind of negates itself. And 0.5% loss for taming chance, but then you get... Okay, so Rhaegal would be the best. He's a Marine. Grace is, okay, so we can try to tame Rhaegal. Because that would just be the best chance, right? Drogon would be the best, but there's a chance that we could get eaten by Drogon. I don't really want that. We have battle is joined. We have captured... We have pursued the Lannister armies. Destroy them. And despite all the heroic victories we're getting, the war score doesn't seem to really reflect that. Battle of Hayford. Battle of Stokeworth. Yeah, okay, whatever. He must have huge armies somewhere else, right? No. Sir Alan. Oh. Alan is, Alan Cave is no longer the, Master Whispers. Wow. Screw you, man. Danos Slint. Ah. His wife is Princess Marcella, who's in our dungeon. Can we send you gold? We can. He doesn't need that much. If we can get him on our side. I know I keep saying that with Master Whispers. Get the Master Whispers on our side. And it generally is a pretty good tactic. Pursue the armies. And we're just going to keep doing this because this is how we keep our advantage. And it only increases us by one point. But here's the thing is, if we let this army escape, it's going to rally again and try to stop us. See, how many allies does he have? He has lots of allies. We have Dorne, Shadowmere. He doesn't have any Lord Paramounts. No, he has Robert of the Vale. Who exactly? No, he's got multiple. He's got Mace Tyrell, Cersei Lannister, the High Septon, who's apparently the same rank as the Lord Paramount, Robert of the Vale. We have got Lord Paramount Littlefinger. We have Dorne. More armies will come. More will come. But once we neutralize this force, we can get back to sieging King's Landing and take the rest of it. Not that it really is going to make a difference. We really need to kidnap King Tommen. We really need to get him in chains. I don't know how plausible that's going to be, though. Because like I said, once you're in hiding, you're almost unkillable. They're all going back to Stokeworth. We will pursue. And my allies are leaving us. I'm not sure why they're leaving us. Keep attacking them.
Good.
Oh, right, we've been here this whole time. Shit. All right, go down to Marine. Go, 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 go. Marine is up here, right? Yes. Watch, Aegon gets scurvy and dies. I would be so pissed. I would call bullshit. We have more levies we can raise.
The 2,000 men.
March them to King's Landing, Walder. Walder, are you a... No, you're a defending expert. Right now, we've got our pursuers, our organizers.
There we go.
All right, are they pulling back to King's Landing? Some are pulling back to Hayford. 23 men are going to King's Landing. Don't let them distract you. It is kind of weird how the AI can do that. They can stack their army so that the top army is going to King's Landing, but the vast majority of the rest of their troops are going somewhere else. And it's a great trick against human players because they, for an instance there, it made them look like they're all going to King's Landing, which if we had done that, Well, they would have. It would have been a good juke on their part. But we're smarter than that. We're not gonna let them trick us like that. I'd love to have those 5,000 Dornishmen with us. Where are they going? I mean, Dorne's not under threat of being attacked. Interesting. And we are currently off the coast of Volantis, so we are well on our way to Meereen. All right, good. We can see our war with the... Oh, shit. Okay. How do we do this? Well, we'll start by fucking not going to King's Landing. Okay, so Mace Tyrell has arrived, and I see now why our wars with this army here have been so pitiful, because they have many, many, many more. Mace Tyrell, damn you, man. So how do we escape this army? We don't have enough ships to ferry us across the Blackwater Bay. Fucking hell. So they're going to cut us off from the south. We really... All right. Let's just try to get as much distance between us and the enemy as possible. Littlefinger, Harrenhal, this area right here should be friendly to us. We just need to get up and around and away from this goddamn army here. We'll keep sieging Fellwood unless we see them start to come down this way. But Jesus, yeah, get our armies out of here. Okay. Yep. Let's go up this way. They're going to rally again. Go to Adranta, and then we'll just kind of go around. We'll take a huge winding arc around. They're going to retake King's Landing. Now, I'm not really that concerned about it. There they go. And while they're doing that, your enemy, Lord Valtrus Sunglass, has been captured. Okay. Are we related to Pentos? Can we do anything? No. Can we ally with anybody here? No. I mean, we could marry somebody, I suppose, but we kind of want to marry Marjorie Tyrell. I was kind of hoping for that. All right. See if we can't make our way down here without getting caught by this goddamn army. All right. Ah, the war with the pirates is over. It's a good start, and I can see already we're already losing the war score because what did they do? Battle of Hayford, lost control of Fellwood, Brickington. How are you undoing my war score like that? That kind of seems like bullshit. I love her, and she loves me. We're both adults, and nobody can stop us from Leonette Wensington. I know she's your lover, man, but we cannot get married to her because that wouldn't aid us. Aegon, are you over here? Ah, you are. Now, Meereen doesn't currently have disease, but it might here soon. It might have the Bloody Flux, and we know how dangerous the Bloody Flux can be. So let's go ahead and drop Aegon, face the fucking dragon, ASAP. But then we also need to make sure our armies over here don't get captured. They cannot go... Where's this army going now? Where is the Reach army going? They're going to Attadale. They're going down here. Yeah, they might be coming for us here in Fellwood soon. Fontaine, do you have mountains? You do. All right, pull back. Pull back, pull back, pull back. And then we'll recombine with this force and give us a solid 10,000 men, and then maybe we can coerce the AI into being stupid some more. They're going to Attadale. They're going down. They're going down. Oh, wow. They're really, really hauling ass. And that's not good. Go to Grassy Vale. Maybe we should go here instead. We're already on our way to Grandview. And that's still in our territory, so we should have the advantage. Walder, you need to hurry your fucking ass up. You're going to get captured here soon by this giant horde of Reachlings. The Pirate Lord Salador's invasion of the Cape Wrath has ended. Good. All right, they're going down to Grassy Vale, so I think we're going to turn around. Has Amberley got any kind of good terrain? Not really. Summerhall, Fontaine has got the mountains. Maybe we should just go there. I don't like this path you're taking, man. I don't like this. How are we going to do this? Maybe we should go fall back into Dorne. I'm thinking that might be the idea. Is Nightsong a liege? Oh, no, they're not a vassal of ours, are they? If you go to... Okay, I like this traveling more. I know it leaves us really open, but that's fine. Now that the armies are relatively safe and we're over here, we should be able to face the dragon. No, we can't. Why can't we? Where is Rhaegal? In Meereen. Face the dragon. Rhaegal is not currently being pursued by another character. Who would dare? Who would dare? Someone is currently trying to get Rhaegal, and we can't let that happen. But right now, we got a war that we can't really afford to lose. Jeez, they are right on his booty. They are right on him. Our Dornish allies are now throwing themselves at the enemy. Oh, God. What are you doing, you fools? You got some mountains here. You got some hills. And we got some mountains. And you are loyal to us. So everybody go to Harvest Hall. I'd love if this army were to chase us. Aegon, Aegon, Aegon. Ah, now we can face the dragon. Good. And look at this. He has been in hiding, and we have so much support to kidnap him. And he's been around for so damn long that we're actually losing support now to kidnap him. I'm telling you, being in hiding is extremely OP. Very, very, very OP. And this guy, we need to get on our side, but he will not join us. Opinion of King Tommen. Yeah, we can't, apparently we can't compete with that. Princess Marcella. She's in our dungeons as well. How do we do this? All right, now they're pulling off. They're going to Griffin's Roost. All right. Fine by me. Doesn't really concern me. All right, how about you guys just go to Potting Field? You don't have to go all the way to the mountains. And it seems our Dornish allies have somehow managed to not get themselves all killed. I appreciate that. Let's see. Walder, new. Roland Storm, we got you. We got Benedict. Where is Martin? There we go. He's ill, though. Or he's got the flu. He's also got a dynastic stain. I'm not sure if that really matters. All right, but our armies have combined once again. Are we reinforcing troops? I'm not sure. Reinforcing 19 soldiers per month. It's really not that much. Face the dragon. I thought we did do that. Didn't we click that option? Maybe we didn't. I forgot. All right, but we got to crush this army here. Oh yes, that's what I like to see. Lots of attrition. I can't actually look at the attrition for some reason. Seems the Reachlanders are pulling back. Let's get up with their army here. I'm kind of concerned about my Dornish allies here. Yeah, are we facing the dragon or not? What's going on here? Which dragon shall we face? Rhaegal. There you go. Make it happen. You've scoured the area in search of Rhaegal, and now you have finally cornered the beast. How shall I deal with him? You are mine. You will attempt to tame and mount Rhaegal. God, I hope we don't get killed for this. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. Let us attempt the taming. You failed to tame the dragon Rhaegal and now will face the consequences. This is the second episode I've recorded today where taming a dragon has failed. This could kill us. 20% chance we die, 50% chance we get wounded, 15% chance we get maimed or burned. That's really not good. That's 30% chance of maiming or burning, 50% chance of wounded. Let's see, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, yeah, so we lose 100 prestige, and there's a good chance we die here. The best case scenario is we walk out of this with a wound. Yeah, Aegon, you are not meant for taming dragons, especially one like Rhaegal. God, this could be the end, ladies and gentlemen. You've been injured. Okay. Best case scenario has happened. Let's forbid you from leading any more armies. We're going to have you go back to Storm's End and lick your wounds while you still fucking can. Oh, that's sad for him. That very well may hurt his chances. All right, we're actually outrunning our allies here. What kind of terrain do they have here? Forest that will give the defenders an advantage. And our allies are being destroyed. They've got more coming too. So organizers are great for travel, but we kind of need All right, Storm's End's got mountains, right? And it's got hills. Let's go to Griffin's Roost. If we can get the enemy to come after us, we can lure them into a false sense of of confidence. My Dornish allies are throwing themselves away. Great. Always glad to see that. We are getting more troops back. 19. We are 19. How many more troops can we raise? Not many. Apparently, Cape Wrath is now our enemy. The bastards. Slippery snakes. So they've got an army of almost 20,000 again. This time made up of Reachmen, Veilmen. Oh, Jesus. Aegon, you're going to have to do something magical here. So they're probably going to go for Storm's End. Let's park ourselves. Well, I mean, I like Griffin's Roost, but if they just stand on top of Storm's End, we lose. So let's get our guys here and get our defending experts on top of Storm's End. I'm deeply hesitant to ask, but the coffers of your subjects. I will give them tax concessions. All right. Okay, they're here in Galemont. Okay, so how are we going to do this? Are we going to wait for them all to come for us? See, this army is going to Parchments. They're going over here. They're going to Parchments as well. I feel like attacking this force here would be a trick. I think that's what the AI wants. Because they're moving this way, and then when we get into battle, they'll just move this way, and they'll get us. So we just kind of need to hold. We need to hold, and we need to let the AI muster their forces together. Despite not being his enemy in war, I still feel as if I can reach out to Danos. I will meet under a armistice. Unfortunately, it appears that Danos does not trust me enough. He certainly has it in with the lions. I'll give him that. But, you know, this force is going to go down the Griffin's Roost. We can easily get them. And our allies are going that way, too. Let's wait till their movement is locked. It seems these armies are pulling back. Wait till their movement gets locked. And we attack. And we don't really have to worry. News from the Battle of Griffin's Roost, my lord. Your bannerman, Lord Harwood Phil, has been slain. Oh, great. By who? Lord Nestor of the Gates of the Moon. All right. It's turning colder. People's winter in Storm's End. Okay. Then what we can do... Let's see. We've got Martin Rivers, Roland Storm, Benedict Broom. Martin, are you an organizer? You are. March down here and destroy this army of the Cape of Wrath. Put those turtles in their place. All right, Colcord out of hiding. Still trying to kidnap King Tommen, but it looks like it's not going to work. Because the bastard is unstoppable. King Tommen is the greatest of the kings. He is better than even Lord Paramount Stannis, apparently. Look at this. Look at this. King Tommen controls the Iron Throne. Oh, yeah, I mean, I suppose we can go back up there and end that once the... Oh, man. The wound is finally healed, leaving nothing but a scar. Alright, that is fine. That's fine. A dirty secret. Just the other day, skulking as I often do, I caught Lord Rene of Griffin's Roost and my courtier Finesse in flagrante? I don't know how to pronounce that. They didn't notice me, but I am still in shock. She is a married woman by the maiden. And supposedly she's honorable. Turns out they'll cheat even if they are honorable. Scandalous, they must be exposed. The flesh is weak. I smell profit. Lord Rene the Red. Ah. I could blackmail him, but he's an important vassal. So I will not do that. We will destroy the turtles. Destroy them. Go to Griffin's Roost, see if we can't goad the Iron Throne into attacking us. I know it seems like there's only 8,000 men, but they're here somewhere. They're here somewhere. My bodyguard, Sir Roland Storm, has expressed a desire to get married. I will find him somebody nice. I will indeed. I know we could probably marry somebody and get their armies, but still kind of holding out that I can marry Marjorie, but it might not happen because King Tommen's kind of OP. Braavos is in the middle of a civil war. Lorath is up here. Mir has only 5,000 men. Tyrosh has 9,000 men. Lys has 10k. Volantis normally has the most men, 27k. Tell me. Do you have a daughter that we could marry? Of House Magir. You do, actually. You do. Do you have any betrothals? Between Aegon and anyone. Alaris Stagon. Okay, she's a Stagon, though. That's not really the same thing. House Magir has no one they can marry to us. Ooh. Well done, sir. Well done. Triarch Malakwo. Volantis would be a great ally to have, but there doesn't really seem to be anybody we can really marry. See, the Reach is against us, the Westlands are against us, the most of the Riverlands is against us, the Vale is against us, the Iron Isles are the Iron Isles, right? Iron King? The Iron King is 17,000 men. Do you have any... I know it's not very honorable to marry a squid. You don't even have any children we can marry. You don't even have them. Actually, no, you do. You've got Gryffa, and you won't do it because you're a bastard. That's why. All right, yep, it seems the game hates Aegon. The game does not want Aegon to be king, and that was evident from the first episode. The wild dragon Drogon is known to attack smaller dragons, and it has been reported that he recently has emerged from his lair near Mother's Valley to attack his cousin Viserion, the ravaged corpse. Okay, great, now Drogon has killed Viserion. Great. This is certainly not a series for the dragon. It seems this is a series for the Tommen, and now they're piling into Storm's End. Yes. I mean, if we can get them to attack us here in Griffin's Roost, that'd be nice. My young prisoner has finished her education in the ways of court and statesmanship. Okay. So they're not going to attack us. They want to sit here and siege Storm's End. Not a bad strategy. But while they're doing that, we could easily go back to King's Landing and take that as well. And that would give us what? 20% chance. Is he still in hiding? He's just going to perpetually be in hiding. That's really, really, really annoying. But if there's even a chance that we can capture him, I say we go for it. I say while they're dicking around down here, we roll up north again and we take King's Landing. Storm's End, they'll be here for some time. And we'll go back for King's Landing. No, go through Amberlee, please. None of this, like, bullshit where you want to go through friendly territories. At this point, no one is a friend. Go for King's Landing a second time. Let's see, how long do we have before they take Storm's End? My prisoner, Marcella Lannister. Nope, you Lannisters will stay where you are. All right, rumors of a traitor working within the castle have lowered the morale of Storm's End. How could they? How could they? Let's see, King Tommen, what kind of Valyrian sword? You have Robert's Warhammer. Of course you do. In fact, you have almost all the swords. You got Fire Sword, you got Heart Eater, Daenerys' Crown, Lightbringer, and Widow's Wail. Are you kidding me? His Lightbringer? All right, let's go ahead and take King's Landing. And that upset the balance quite wholeheartedly. Nice. We will focus on taking King's Landing now. If we're going to do that, we need Siege Experts. We need Siege Experts. Let's get Aenys. And since we're probably not going to be running away, maybe we can replace Roland Storm with some more Siege Experts. Benedict Broom, we will replace you with Richard Morgan. And we'll get all of our... Actually, Aenys, you belong on the flank. Yep, there you go. And then we'll get Raleigh. And then we'll get... who was the last one? Not Raleigh. Last one was you, Richard! Okay, so let's get the timer going one more time. Yeah, if Storm's End falls, that's not going to be good. Do we have Stalwart Defender? Still, no. So I haven't really gotten the option to go into hiding. And it might not even give it to me because... Okay. Okay, this is a new development. 293%. That is huge. 300% plot power, but if it will not launch because he's in hiding, then that's bullshit. I call bullshit on that one. My lord and enemy host approaches intent on encircling the castle. What shall we do? We will take our family into hiding. Now, will we have a regency? I bet we will. What kind of regency would that look like? Our regency would be Lady Maria, who is the Lady of Parchments. She really, really likes us. Granted a high lordship, vassal transfer, chosen inheritor. She's also an adulteress. Is there anyone else we can choose as our designated regent that'd be good? Varys, our lover Leonette. We will go into hiding. Thank you. Why? Because hiding is OP as hell. We'll just hide forever. And it doesn't really seem to matter. And then we're going to take King's Landing. I'm wondering if assaulting the Dragon Gate would be useful. The Dragon Gate. Could wait till it gets down to about 50%. Would that work? Let's try to take it now. There we go. Alright, so this episode has been a lot of back and forth. And now we have a huge army standing outside of Storm's End. We're retaking King's Landing. We have an enormous plot amount of plot power to take King Tommen, but he's still in hiding, and apparently he's hiding in the void or something. He's in some other dimension, calculating, if I can make my hand gesture, calculating, can't really do it with my mic on the way, but he's a mastermind from another dimension, hiding in the void with Sithis, where he can't be touched by anybody. And I call bullshit, but that, ladies and gentlemen, will all have to be in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. As always, if you want to help support me make more content, be sure to head on over to my Patreon page, found link in the about page. It's probably on the original page too. If you can probably find the icon somewhere. I have been the Golden Joeblivion, and until next time, I will see you all later.